Morgan, you still feel there's a lot of upside potential to gold and silver in 2018?
Oh, yes, and further. I think we're going to see a good year in 2018, and we'll see further appreciation through 2019-2020.
But last time we spoke, you were saying how you felt there is no silver deficit, which I think is an ongoing debate in the industry. So how does that build a bullish case for the metal?
Well, I built the case that the above-ground supply of silver has increased from 2006 onward. That's a fact. Now, you'll get a counter argument that, yeah, but you're not accounting for investment demand, which is the way that the World Silver Survey looks at it, and they'll tell you there's a deficit. But I think the easiest, safest, most productive way for people to think about it is whether or not the above ground inventory of silver is depleting or increasing. It depleted from 1990 to 2006. Right. From 2006 to 2018, it's increased. But that doesn't mean that it's not a bad investment. I also showed a chart that showed the silver price during a deficit, which was like 10 bucks at the max. And as the inventory is building for 3 or 4 years, the price hit 50. And that, I think, is the most important point, because people think supply and demand really, you know, is what's so important. It is the demand at the margin that matters. And that could happen when there's a bunch of silver above ground. People have got to think a little bit.
Okay, that's a good point. So where do you think, where's the demand coming for from silver right now? Is it still China?
Yeah, there's industrial demand has increased substantially over the last 20 years. However, it's sort of flattened out. And the margin is where it counts, and that's investment demand. Coin demand last year in 2017 is estimated by the World Silver Survey to be one half of what it was the previous year. So there's been a big fall off in investment demand, and the price kind of reflects that.
Obviously important to look at the gold-silver ratio. It has been climbing higher here. It closed at almost 79 as of Friday's close. What do you make of this? You know, does it mean that gold's becoming overvalued, or is it just silver that's suppressed here?
I think a little of both. It's a good trade. I mean, when you get to 80, it's probably a good time if you're metals bullish or even gold-centric to trade your gold into silver. And then when the ratio gets back to whatever, 60, 50 to 1, something like that, you might reverse that trade and turn your silver back into gold. I made that statement at the Vancouver Resource Conference 15 years ago for the gold-only people, because silver was at about an 80 to 1 ratio at that time. So I think it's an opportunity if you are willing to take the risk.
So that said, I know here at the conference a lot of people calling for 1,400, 1,425 gold, some even saying 1,500 gold in 2018. What's your forecast, and where do you also see silver?
I see probably like the majority, 1,450 or so. I also know for a fact that 1,550 gold confirmed with about $22 an ounce silver will get us moving substantially. Until we meet those metrics, we're going to see a more or less lackluster gold and silver market. I see silver following gold this time, not leading. I think that we're going to have a good year for both, but if gold goes up, whatever, this year, let's say it does a repeat of 11 to 15%, I think silver will double that this year. So I think silver will outperform this year.
David Morgan, thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.